Let's get started. This is March Favorites, all my favorite beauty products for the month of March. And I want to start with a hair care treatment, and it's using coconut oil as a scalp treatment. My scalp has been extremely dry and flaky over the last month, so I kept reading about the benefits of coconut oil and I decided to try it out as a scalp treatment. I just scoop it up in my hands, I massage it as much as I can, all over my scalp. I leave it on for about 10 minutes, then I wash it out. I do have to shampoo twice just to make sure I get it all out, but ever since I started doing this, my scalp has not had any issues. It hasn't been itchy, it hasn't been flaky, nothing bad has been happening. I do this about once a week, once every other week, as necessary, and I love it. Now, the coconut oil that I use is from Whole Foods, and this one also has vanilla lavender extract in it, so it smells a little bit more interesting than just your basic coconut oil, but you can definitely use whatever coconut oil you have on hand. The next hair product I've loved this month is the Serge Normand Dry Conditioner. This is awesome. It's an argan oil based conditioner. It's in a spray form. It's super, super light. It just looks like hairspray, but since the ends of my hair are highlighted and fried and processed, they are definitely more prone to being dry than the rest of my hair. So I've been using this kind of in between washes just to freshen things up. My hair feels super, super soft and smooth whenever I put this in. But my hair is very fine and quite thin, so oily products can show up and can make my hair feel weighed down and greasy, but this does not do that. If you do have thicker hair and more coarse hair that can handle more oil, I think you would really like this. This is the Agadir oil treatment. I get this from Amazon. My friend Vanessa from the Bombshell Suite introduced me to this product years ago, and I've been buying it ever since. This is more of an intensive treatment for me. If I go too crazy with this, my hair can look a little bit greasy. But if you do have thicker, drier, coarser hair, I think that you would really love this. This is a great oil treatment just for in between washes when you just want to give your ends a little bit of extra love. The next product that I've been loving this month is the First Aid Beauty Slow Glow Gradual Self-Tanning Moisturizer. I was away on vacation, but I didn't really tan for real. I just used sunscreen every day and then I fake tanned with this. This is awesome. It just gives you a hint of glow to your skin. No streaks whatsoever. I didn't even use a mitt with it. Usually when I use the Saint Tropez Gradual Self-Tanning Lotion, I always end up getting streaks no matter what I do, and I'm just very impatient with it. But this one actually feels more like a thick moisturizer. It doesn't give you a dramatic tan the way the Saint Tropez does, but it builds up really slowly. It makes you look like you just got a natural glow, and it's awesome. It also doesn't smell that bad. It has a very faint hint of fake tan smell about 2 hours in, but it's very non-offensive. It's very manageable. It's not that bad. And the actual moisturizer itself is super, super hydrating. In terms of skincare, my skin has been extra sensitive and dehydrated this month, so I had to kind of change the tune. I stopped using the more heavy-duty acid exfoliating things that I was using, and I tried to use a more gentle approach. So these are the masks and exfoliating treatments that I've been loving this month. The first is from the brand Pi. Pi is one of my favorite skincare brands. They cater to sensitive skin only. All of their stuff is plant-based. Their Camellia Cream Cleanser is one of my favorite products. And this is their Copaiba Deep Cleanse AHA Mask. When you apply this, this actually has a thick cream-like texture. It feels nice and hydrating, but it also gently exfoliates your skin with AHAs at the same time. When you rinse it off, they recommend you rinse it off using a washcloth. When you take it off, your skin is just left feeling very comfortable, hydrated, and a little bit more luminous than before. And it smells really good too. It smells like lemon meringue pie or something like that. This is really good. And I highly recommend it if you have dry and sensitive skin. Another product, if you are more combination, more congested, acne prone, oily, this product is worth a try as well. This is by the brand Tula. This is the exfoliating treatment mask with probiotic technology. This has lactic acid in it and it also has bentonite clay. It's a very purifying mask that also gently exfoliates using both lactic acid, and it has a little bit of like volcanic sand granules in it as well. This is what it looks like. The color is really pretty and blue. The scent is very clean and refreshing, and whenever I use this about once a week whenever I feel like my skin is getting a bit congested. Sometimes I use it all over my face, sometimes I just use it on the areas where I am getting congested, like my chin usually gets congested and my nose. This is really good. It feels like it's actually helping to decongest your skin, but it's not overly drying like other clay masks. Then the other product in the same family that I've been loving is the Amora Pacific Enzyme Peel. This is fantastic. It's a powder-based product. Make sure your face is damp and your hands are damp. You apply the powder, you work it into a lather, you apply it on the skin, and it just softly and gently polishes the skin. It kind of foams up a little bit, but it's all very gentle. It has a really nice sweet scent. So I just kind of massage the lather into the skin for a couple minutes. Then when I wash it off, my skin just feels baby soft. So, so nice. So another really, really good gentle exfoliating option. The last skincare product I wanted to talk about is a moisturizer. Now this was sent to me from Clarins. This is the Clarins Multi-Active Night Cream. This is the normal to combination version. They do have a dry skin version and an all skin type version. I don't really understand why they have one that's for all skin types, but then they have one that's for normal to combination and then one for dry. It doesn't really make sense, but anyway, this is a really good moisturizer. I'm not a big fan of the jar packaging. It seems like most night creams come in a jar packaging and there's nothing you can do about it. The texture of this night cream is very light. It sinks into the skin quickly. It just feels like a blanket of moisture on the skin, and I really, really like the scent of it. It's a very light, herbal, fresh scent, and I love it. I find it really comforting, and it just feels great. Sometimes I apply it on top of an oil, sometimes I just apply it over a serum at night, and I just feel like this really has helped calm down the dehydration levels of my skin, and it just has made my skin feel really nice and comfortable. It's got hyaluronic acid in it and a bunch of yummy plant extracts. In terms of makeup products, I only have two things to share with you, and they're both drugstore products. Drugstore products have been kicking ass lately, and this is my current Holy Grail eyebrow product, and it's by L'Oreal. It's the L'Oreal Brow Stylist Plumper. I bought the shade light to medium because I do have highlighted hair and I naturally have very dark eyebrows, and then I find that this deposits just enough color to lighten my eyebrows, maybe a shade, and just to make them look a little bit softer, and it kind of works with my hair color more. It's a great eyebrow gel. It keeps my eyebrows in place, and it also deposits quite a bit of color and helps fill them in a little bit. This is a great product, and if you have not tried it yet, give it a try. The next thing is this little contour kit from Maybelline. This is the Maybelline Master Contour Face Contour Kit. This is the lightest shade. I think they have a darker option as well. And this is what it looks like. You get a contour, blush, and highlight in a very useless brush. It's just got rough synthetic bristles that don't pick up the product, and it doesn't really do anything. I actually use the brush to clean the compact itself of any fallout. So anyway, the actual compact is quite nice. I really like the contour shade. It has more warmth to it than a traditional contouring powder, but I love it for lazy mornings where I don't want to contour and bronzer. I just dip my brush into this. I get a nice definition around my face and I'm good to go. The blush color is a beautiful pink, and it also comes with a highlighting shade. I'm not a crazy fan of highlighter in general, but it is a nice color. It's a little bit patchy. I definitely prefer the contour and the blush shade in this kit, but it does the job, it's affordable, and I've been using it almost every day this month. It's just easy. Get up in the morning, get ready for work. I just can just grab one compact and my contour and my cheeks are good. So those are all the beauty products that I have loved. I have two non-beauty favorites that I wanted to mention, and the first is the shirt that I'm wearing right now. It is a white t-shirt from Topshop, and I love it. And I just got it a couple weeks ago in Dubai, but it's available online on Topshop. So I thought that I would show it and link it just in case you're interested. I love the fact that it's a simple white cotton t-shirt, but it's got this really beautiful feminine mesh detailing that elevates it a little bit and makes it look a little bit more special. You can just wear it plain with some boyfriend jeans and some sneakers. You can dress it up with some black leather leggings and some heels. It's super versatile, feminine, playful, and cute. And then the other thing is a YouTuber, and I've really been loving Jess Beautician this month. I am obsessed with her What I Eat in a Day videos. They're my favorite videos of hers to watch. She is vegan, and she makes eating vegan look so delicious. Highly recommend you check out her channel. She also does beauty videos and she just has awesome content and she deserves more subscribers. So I'm going to put the link to her channel below, especially her What in My Eat videos, her What I Eat in a Day videos are fantastic. They will make you really hungry and really happy at the same time. I just want to cook everything she makes in those videos. So that's about it for me. I hope you have had a fantastic March and I will see you in my next video. Bye. Just hold on.